Mount Baldusar Pass. We will take you through their magical journey. Himalayas have always been the dream of mountaineers and trekkers. Many would have wanted to take that off the bucket list. Here's a small journey of the brave women from Karnataka who have now successfully trekked their way through Mount Baldusar Pass. Fortnight-long expedition, the women between 13 and 65 years of age passed through various camps in the Himalayas before reaching the summit of Mount Baldusar Pass, situated at a height of 14,500 feet on the border of Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. Located at an altitude of about 4,400 meters above sea level, between the Rupin and Supin valleys, the Baldusar Lake is close to the border of Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. The initial path is through a green valley and takes you to rocky surface, which makes it a bit difficult. Before they left Karnataka to scale Baldusar Lake, after undergoing endurance training for 3 weeks, the trekkers, hailing from Shivamoga, Madikeri, Hasan, Chikbalapur, Mysuru and Bengaluru, assembled in Mysuru and left for the expedition on April 17th. Deepak Solanki of International Academy of Mountaineering and Allied Sports, who has been organizing trekking expeditions for more than 2 decades, said the recent expedition to Baldusar Pass by women was the first of its kind in the adventure history of Karnataka.
The concept of Nari Shakti was picked up from 2015 when our Honorable Prime Minister of our country, Mr. Narendra Bhai Modi, gave a call of empowering the Stree Shakti Rider. And this is starting from April 17th, and we will go and climb Baldusar Pass, which is a lake at a height of 14,500 feet in Uttarakhand. And it is going to be amazing trek with 27 ladies in the team, rather females, and 6 males accompanying them to realize their dream. And hope we all make it to the top and we come back with successful accolades and memories to come, and we share with you all once we come back.
Bus journeys are always fun. Just before starting out their expedition routine, on their way to the base camp, the women went all out and enjoyed their journey. Truly, no bus journeys go without a little thumkas. A little prayer in Himachal Pradesh. The women performed the early morning prayers and took divine blessings beside the river. They also performed aarti before their trek. Yoga and dance go hand in glove even at an elevation. As said by Solanki before leaving Mysuru, the group was inspired by Modi and his emphasis on yoga and the importance of it. So they decided to perform their yoga at the first base. Long hectic day, what's more refreshing than a dance session by the crew members? another day, another adventure. But first, let's get fitness training. Before scaling a mountain range like the Himalayas, it requires endurance and some fitness training. Hence, the crew went through a vigorous training. Small kids were also seen working hard.
Very good, Shara. Come on. Well doing. Well going, Sunita. Very good. Savita, good going. Atla, good going. Arjun, very good.
The D-Day was here. The expedition begins from base one. Trekking rocks and crossing rivers, all part of the journey. On day one, members had to trek over tough rocks and crawl through caves to reach to the other side. Even small kids were seen crawling through these huge boulders. In fact, few even felt like a kid and remembered their childhood. Right after the trek, the women and men had to rough their way across rivers to reach their second base. Prep talk is always a motivator. A small prep talk from their guide sure did motivate them to climb to the next big chunk of their expedition through the snow. Sharing each other's experience and motivating each other, they geared up to summit Mount Barathasar.
Talk to yourself every day, otherwise you'll miss sleeping in amazing moments.
Okay, that's something new for me. Thank you for telling me.
The crew hits the snow at last, conquer their way. Look at our Karnataka women crew, shaming everyone who play by gender stereotypes. From old women to small kids, all move their way up the mountain energetically. They reached base 3. Here's Suma explaining her experience scaling up the mountain.
ನಾನು ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ಹಿಮಾಲಯನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್‌ಪೆಡಿಷನ್ ಗೆ ಬಂದಿರೋದು. ತುಂಬಾ ಎಕ್ಸೈಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇನ್ನು ಒಂದೇ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ನಾವು ಸಮಿತ್ ಗೆ. ಸಾಂಕ್ರಿ ಬೇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಇಂದ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಬೇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು ನಾವು ಖಾಸ್ಲಾಗೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎರಡನೇ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಢಾಲ್ಡಾಲ್ ಸುರಾಲ್, ಮೂರನೇದು ಢಾಲ್ಡಾಲ್. ಈಗ ನಾಲ್ಕನೇ ಬೇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಸಮಿತ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ದೇವಭಾಸ ನೇಚರ್ ಜೊತೆ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರೋದು ಬಹಳ ಖುಷಿಯಾಗಿದೆ, ತುಂಬ ಎಕ್ಸೈಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಇನ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ಡ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 9 ಡೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ವೆಟ್ ದಿ ಟೀಮ್ ರೀಚ್ ದ ಸಮಿಟ್. ಆನ್ ಏಪ್ರಿಲ್ 27th ದೇ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ ದ ಟ್ರೈಕಲರ್ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೈಡ್. ದ ನಾರಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೈಸೂರು who finally did what they set out to do, said they were proud to be women and they are no less than a man.
Thumbs up! Everybody thumbs up!
Thumbs up!
Victory, we for Nari Shakti!
Yay! Yeah. Thanks to...
Dr. Buzz!
Amar
Nari! Dr. Buzz!
Amar Nari!
Dr. Buzz!
Amar Nari!
Bhaiya ki Nariya, jisne aaj dikha diya hai ki...
हिमालय पर चढ़ाई करना उनकी भी बस की बात है.
नारी शक्ति
Just look at the mountaineers holding the Indian flag, marking their territory and marking their win.
विराट सर बस
हमारा है.
विराट सर बस
हमारा है.
विराट सर बस
हमारा है.
नारी शक्ति
जिंदाबाद.
नारी शक्ति
जिंदाबाद.
नारी शक्ति
जिंदाबाद.
And the descent begins. However disappointing it may be to leave a beautiful and scenic place like that, everything good must come to an end. The team began their descent and returned to Mysuru. In Mysuru, by Soto, the team was received by their family members with sweets and garlands. Even felicitated at the government school for surviving a fortnight in the Himalayas and conquering a daunting peak. Yes, they shut up anyone doubting what women are capable of. More importantly, what Indian women are capable of. A Newsline report.